Well, the story of Le Mans in 1970 really begins from the year before, because and that was the year we were in the lead by a large amount, 6 laps, with only 3 hours to go. Because the gearbox failed, the following year's choice of configuration of the car was what we ended up with in 1970, which ended up in winning, but for me, the car was not going to be fast enough. In 69 we had a 5-speed box, but unfortunately, in a way, probably to make the gearbox stronger, they made it only a 4-speed box, giving us a massive disadvantage because the torque of the bigger engine was far greater. And I calculated that we were losing 3 seconds per lap on both Mulsanne and Arnage. So that's twice, 6 seconds, a lot. From my point of view, before we started, after qualifying, I said to myself, we absolutely have no chance of winning this race because we're not going to be near enough the front to be able to do so. And a lot of people think that we held back and then come through gloriously and everything else, but that wasn't the case at all. We simply could not do anything about it. It was as simple as that. We weren't racing like it was a sprint race. It was, we both, Hans and I, knew it was a 24-hour race. And you do, well, I drive, and he did as well, drove that race in a different way than you would with a 1,000-kilometer race. I think at the time it was a record race for the fewest finishers. The attrition rate was just unbelievable. And I didn't start the race, Hans started the race. And I watched, and it seemed to me like it was a Grand Prix. And I think they all were going for a win early on. And the psychology of that race at that time particularly is completely different to today. Today, the race is the drivers drive pretty much, well, they do, they drive flat out. We had a trouble-free run. I mean, yes, there was a lot of rain, which came on, I don't know what, but there was a lot of the race was in the rain, and a lot of rain. And I think today, if the race had been run in those conditions, a pace car definitely would have been sent out. And that was the biggest challenge we had. It was in the end, just to finish, without doing something stupid, and we won it by default of others, really. Well, I recall that Derek Bell and, I don't know, 2 other Ferraris, all in Ferraris, 3 Ferraris, were out pretty much in one accident. So it was unbelievable what was going on out there. And after 10 hours, we're in the lead. I mean, I could not believe what must have gone on out there. The thing that really took the mind was we got to do 14 hours in terrible conditions, and all we had to do, only had to do, was finish the race, and that was the challenge. I was asked a question the other day, you know, what was it like to drive 917 in the way down the Mulsanne straight at 200 miles? I said, quite honestly, we didn't. You know, you couldn't. You tuned your speed according to the conditions, and that was the difficulty. We weren't in danger of losing the race by being caught by anybody, I don't think. But we could easily lose a race another way. But the relevance of it didn't come to me for some years after, really. It didn't.